Hey, this is Jamie from the Attack for Enterprise team, and we're going to spend a couple of minutes talking about how an idea becomes an attack technique. Our team spends a lot of time both creating and maintaining techniques, and we hope that a peek inside this process helps you better use techniques as well as understand how you can potentially help as a contributor. So what actually goes into an attack technique? Well, we start with publicly available information highlighting behaviors used by real threat actors as well as malware. We then contextualize that with additional threat intelligence, as well as research and technical background. And finally, with the bigger goal of attack, we connect this technique with the defensive countermeasures in the forms of mitigations and detections. And again, it can't be repeated enough that attack techniques are built based on what real adversaries are doing in the wild, gathered from publicly available threat intelligence, as well as insights and contributions from the attack community. So going into a little bit more detail about how the attack team develops techniques, we can define a six-step process, starting with step one, researching the adversary behavior as well as related offensive tradecraft. Step two involves researching and documenting technical background and details. Our goal with attack technique descriptions is that they can be easily read and understood by anyone, including a rubber ducky. So at this point, we have a good description of the adversary behavior and the surrounding technical context. So for step three, we connect that knowledge to defensive countermeasures in the form of mitigations and data sources and detections. And just like that, we have a drafted technique, but it's not quite yet ready to be published as we need to perform various checks for both quality, accuracy, and usability. And one of the most important checks we perform is looking back at the original threat intelligence that helped create the technique, as well as additional examples to make sure that this technique is really capturing the behavior and can be used by analysts. And finally, we have a technique ready to be published in the next update to attack. But even after initial publication, we periodically review techniques as well as keep an eye out for additional threat intelligence, contributions, or any other information or insights that can help us grow and evolve existing techniques. So we're back at the matrix view of attack, but hopefully now you have a better understanding and appreciation for everything that goes into techniques, including the name and description, procedure examples, and finally, defensive countermeasures in the form of detections and mitigations. We've spent a long time talking about what the MITRE attack team does, but we can never forget that none of this is possible without the amazing community of people sharing information about threats. If you wish to contribute directly to attack, guidance is available on our site, but feel free to shoot us an email. But fair warning, for any ideas about new techniques, we will be asking about how that relates to real threats. It really is exciting to be a part of the growth of attack, especially as we look back and appreciate how the framework has evolved over the years. But a couple extra tips about contributions. Please thoroughly review attack before sending ideas, but also we get a lot of contributions, so please be patient with us. And that's our time. I hope this was not only enlightening, but also as enjoyable for you as it was for me. Cheers.